So as many of you may know, I am the director of network operations. I entered the IT field 3 years ago with no degree and no IT certifications. There's many different things and factors that contributed to my success. So stay tuned, because in this video, I'm going to tell you my story and hopefully share some advice that will help you succeed in the IT career field. Coming up. So I bet you're wondering, how was I able to advance my career so quickly? 3 years is a very short amount of time to go from a complete entry-level help desk position to a director-level position. Well, let's start from the beginning. I was a bulldozer operator before I entered the IT career field, and I was making actually really good money at a job that most would consider a lifelong career position. But I just wasn't happy. I was working crappy hours, the job was mind-numbing, boring, and there was no room for advancement in my company. I had already maxed out in my position. On my lunches and breaks, I started watching YouTube videos about the IT field and what it took to get into the IT field. I remembered back in high school, I took a Cisco networking course and really enjoyed it. And I'd always had a passion for technology. So right away, I started doing some research on what it would actually take to make a career change. You know, someone that was a college dropout, had no prior work experience, no certifications, was it actually possible for me to get a position in the IT field? So right away, one of the first two things I did was signed up for a CompTIA A+ course and started studying right away. The other thing I did was started brushing up my resume and started applying for jobs. I didn't wait till I had my certification. I wanted out, I wanted to follow my dream, and I just started putting my resume, applying, and talking to anyone who would listen. I knew since I had such a great job, I was probably gonna have to take a pay cut, and I was gonna have to start all over at the bottom. I was gonna have to start at a basic entry-level help desk position. I knew I was gonna take this pay cut entering the IT field, but I knew if I worked hard and focused on what I was doing, I would quickly be back up and surpass what I was making as a bulldozer operator. I started going on websites like Meetup and finding networking events where other technology people were meeting up and talking business and stuff like that. I started introducing myself to people and trying to get a feeling of what employers were looking for in the IT career field. I spent hours searching the web, looking at different job posting, looking at what the requirements for every type of job that I was interested in, and trying to figure out what skills I needed to make myself a valid candidate. Like most people, I think I had this notion in my mind that I had to have IT certifications before I could start working in the IT career field. And right away, let me tell you, that is not the case. Don't get me wrong, IT certifications are great door openers to any position, but they are absolutely not required to get an entry-level position in the IT field. One of my biggest tips to everyone is if you're interested in getting into the IT field, start applying for jobs today. No matter where you are, if you have IT certifications or not, if you have prior experience or not, start applying today, because you never know who else is applying, and you very well might be the most qualified person that's applying for that position. So getting back to my story, I started applying for jobs before I finished studying for my CompTIA A+. But on my resume, I listed that I was currently studying for my A+ and listed that I had scheduled my exam date out. And just after a few interviews, I was actually offered a position as a entry-level IT support specialist, which leads me to my next tip for you guys. One of the most important skills in the IT field is your soft skills, your ability to communicate with others and be able to talk to someone and be personal to them. It was my soft skills that actually landed me that entry-level position. Most employers can train you on how to reset passwords and all the other hard skills you actually need to know in the IT field. But those soft skills, those skills that you develop through your life on how to communicate with people, those are the hardest ones to teach. If you have great soft skills and the ability to communicate with others, you will really go far in this career field. Now, don't worry if you don't have soft skills. If you are not a people person, you can still build those skills over time. It just becomes a little bit more difficult. You have to learn and put yourself out there how to talk to people. Go to more networking events. Go to websites like meetup.com. Check out LinkedIn for networking events in your area where you can meet up with people and just start talking to people and getting a feel for the people in your area and what they're looking for. And by doing so, you'll learn how to communicate with people better. So while I was applying for entry-level positions, I really started digging into different knowledge, and I didn't really have a lot of money to pay for these different online e-learning platforms. So YouTube became a huge resource. You know, YouTubers like Professor Messer, IT Career Questions, they were huge to getting my start in the IT career field, where They were giving me the knowledge and teaching me the skills I needed to know. And I just ran wild with that stuff. It was like a thirst I couldn't quench. I just wanted as much information as possible and was watching these videos pretty much every waking moment I had free time. Came across these two YouTubers called Juan Lightfoot and Network Chuck. And in both of their videos, they were talking about building your own home networking lab. And I knew networking was a huge passion of mine. So I went out and bought my own Cisco equipment. I went out and bought some basic Cisco gear and started playing around with it. Started playing around the command line, did different configurations with that. And when I was going on my interviews, I was actually talking about my home lab. And most of the people that were interviewing me were shocked that I had taken the time to purchase some basic equipment off of eBay and play around with the configuration. It was way more than any of the other potential job candidates were doing. I would tell them about these different configurations I would do, and then I would break it and factory reset it and reload my configuration. And these employers were just shocked that I was able to do all this without any formal training. I was just thirsty for knowledge. And it's little things like that that make the difference when you're going for these job interviews. It's things like that. You are building experience in the IT career field. You might not be doing it for an employer or for anyone, but you're still getting experience with real world tools. And I'm not talking about spending a lot of money on a home lab. These switches I pulled off of eBay for like 20, 30 bucks. I actually have a few of them linked down in the description. If you are interested in building your own Cisco networking lab, go check that out. You don't need to spend a lot of money to get some real world equipment. You actually can do it for free with a program called Packet Tracer. Cisco has this program called Packet Tracer where it simulates networking environments and you can build a home lab. But for me personally, I liked putting my hands on the equipment. I liked connecting all the different cables. It really meant more to me doing it that way. So once I landed that first entry level position, I really made it my mission to learn as much as I could and was constantly studying and learning different technologies. I knew I had a huge passion for networking, so I tried to learn as many networking skills as possible and let it be known to my employer that I was studying for networking and try to get involved with any networking changes that were happening. One big pointer in the IT career field is you always have to be learning new skills. The IT field is constantly evolving and you have to constantly be studying to keep up with the times. Myself, I'm constantly studying for new certifications. I personally enjoy using online e-learning platforms like INE, CBT Nuggets, Pluralsight. I've actually linked to a couple different online e-learning platforms down in the description. If you use our link, some of them, you will actually get a discount on your annual subscriptions. So really quick, if you guys have any questions at all about entering the IT field, let me know in the comments below. I try to get back to every single one of you. I know making a career or job change can be super stressful. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to let me know. So getting back to my IT career journey, I was an IT support specialist for actually 2 years with this company. And when I first started with the company, I was doing basic things like resetting email passwords, setting up Active Directory user accounts, stuff like that. But I quickly evolved my skills and started doing more with their networking environment. And by the time I left this company, I was designing the complete IT infrastructure for brand new hotels we were building. It was a blast and I really enjoyed doing it. But after 2 years, I had some life events happen and I had to actually move closer to family and I had to leave that job. It was a great job, but I need to be close to family again. So right after I moved, I started applying for jobs again. And I figured, well, the first time around when I got my first position, I was hired pretty quickly, should be pretty easy. And I used a very similar resume to my first job I applied for, just updated it. But I wasn't getting calls for interviews and I didn't understand why. And I kept on applying and I wasn't getting any calls. I'm like, wait a minute, I have more experience. I have a certification now. Why am I not getting calls for these basic entry-level positions that I'm totally qualified for? And I finally realized it was my resume. My resume wasn't doing me justice. So I completely threw out my resume and started from scratch. You know, I had this beautiful, nice 2-page resume, but it was just too busy and it wasn't highlighting my key skills. I simplified down into this 1-page resume where I really highlighted and bullet pointed my skills. And then boom, as soon as I redid my resume, I was getting tons of calls for interviews. So that's one thing to keep in mind is if you're applying for jobs and not getting called for interviews, it might not be you. It might just be your resume. You might need to rewrite your resume. So I got a job for a short amount of time with my local school district as a networking engineer. And it wasn't a bad job and it was a good stepping stone, but it really wasn't what I wanted to be doing. The school district had a lot of political policies and a lot of political stuff around it. And I just really wasn't happy there. And I actually applied for a job as a NOC technician, a network operations center technician at my current company, and was quickly hired on there to help with the NOC operations. And once again, I poured myself into this position. I tried to make it my mission to learn everything about everything there. I tried to learn all the different systems and how they were connected. And it was a bit of a learning challenge for me because I came from a complete Cisco environment. And all my life, I've really studied Cisco networking. And at this new company, they didn't do anything with Cisco. They were a Juniper shop. And I didn't really know the difference in the command line from Cisco to Juniper. But one thing I kept in mind is networking is networking. And once you know how everything works together, going from different vendors is really easy. It didn't take very long for my hard work and dedication to get noticed. And just after my 90-day review, I was actually promoted to Director of Network Operation. This was my dream job. This was my moment to do what I dreamed of all along. And I was so super pumped. So really quick, let me just say, my career path isn't the normal. Normally, most people aren't able to accelerate into a director level position within 3 years of entering the field. It is absolutely possible. I'm not saying it is not possible, but it is not normal. You have to be very dedicated and constantly be learning and trying to improve yourself and give that 200% to be able to be successful. It is possible. Don't get me wrong. It is absolutely possible, but it takes a lot of dedication. At the time of recording this, I've been in that position for about a year and I've been absolutely loving it. Throughout my career, I've been able to help many people follow their dreams and succeed. And like I said, if you are looking to get into the IT career field, don't wait until you have IT certifications. Go out and apply for a job today. Just start applying and start talking to people and you will get your foot in through the door. If you are looking for IT certifications to study, I've actually created a video talking about the top IT certifications in 2022. I've actually linked it down in the description. Go check that out if you are still insistent on getting an IT certification before you start. One thing to keep in mind when you're applying for jobs in the IT career field, a lot of times these job descriptions, these qualifications that are required by employers are more of a wish list. They're there to try to wean out some of the people that, you know, just some of the noise. Like I said, they're more of a wish list. So go out there and start applying for the job. And even if you don't meet all the qualifications, don't lie on your application. Don't say that you know stuff that you don't, but just go out and apply and be honest about your knowledge. You never know. You might be the most qualified person to apply for that job. And when you go for that interview, they might decide they really like your personality and think you'd be a good fit with their team. And that could land you the job right there. I know because that's happened to me before. I really hope this video gave you the motivation you need to apply for that entry-level position and make a career change. Or if you're already working in the IT career field, I hope it gave you the motivation to apply for that next level position. And if you're still trying to figure out what IT certifications you should be taking this year, I actually just created a brand new video listing the top IT certifications you guys should be studying for. If you've made it this far in the video and you have any questions, please make sure and put them down in the comments below. I try to get back to every single one. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. All right, everyone. Thank you for tuning in. And until next time, take it easy.